Hey everyone, welcome back to the fourth part of our realistic portrait drawing series featuring Rohit Sharma. In today's video, we will tackle some most defining aspects of his portrait like the nose, lips and beard, etc. These elements add so much personality and depth, so it's essential to approach them with precision and care. So grab your materials and let's get started. The art supplies are going to be same as in the last video, and here you can see them all. Let's begin with the right eye. We will use a similar technique as in the previous video for left eye, but I will walk you through each step again to ensure clarity. Remember, the eyes are the windows to the soul and are often the most expressive feature in any portrait. Capturing their details accurately is crucial to bringing the entire piece to life. Start by refining the outlines of eye. Keep them clean and sharp for realistic structure. Next, use a soft charcoal pencil to add darker tones to the iris. Be mindful of leaving small highlights in the iris to give a lifelike sparkle. Now, to integrate the eyes seamlessly into the portrait, I am adding a base layer of shading to the nose. This helps establish the correct proportions and positioning for the eyes and surrounding features. Now, returning to the right eye, let's shade the sclera, the white part of the eye. Even though it appears white, it contains subtle shadows near the corners and edges, adding depth and dimension. Use a soft brush with residual graphite to apply a delicate, even shade. Then, to make the eye appear three-dimensional, darken the shadows along the upper eyelid where it overlaps the eyeball. Lightly shade the lower eyelid to emphasize its natural curve. Now, let's move above the eye to the eyebrow. Use fine strokes that follow the direction of hair growth to mimic the natural texture. Start with light strokes and gradually build up the darker areas, particularly near the arc of the brow, where the hair is typically denser. Take your time with this step. As I shade, I frequently step back to evaluate the balance between light and shadow, ensuring that both eyes look harmonious and consistent. This regular check-in helps maintain the symmetry and flow of the portrait. Now, let's shift your focus to the nose, a central feature that defines the character of the face. After applying a base layer of shading, deepen the shadows under the nostrils and along the sides of the nose to give it a sense of volume. To highlight the bridge of the nose, use a kneaded eraser to lift some graphite, creating a natural shine that mimics how light interacts with the skin. Additionally, enhance the skin texture by using a blending stump or precision eraser to create subtle details, ensuring the nose looks lifelike or integrated with the rest of the face. The right cheek not have prominent dark shadows, but adding subtle shading will help to balance light and shadows across the face, enhancing the overall structure and depth. Begin by applying a base light skin tone, ensuring the cheekbone area remains slightly lighter to represent more light hitting in the spot. This will create a natural highlight and define the facial contours. In the next step, carefully observe the reference photo and gradually build up all the shadows, focusing on subtle transition to achieve a realistic effect. Use a soft brush and soften the edges and add a sense of depth. Pay close attention to the details on the cheek and meticulously draw every pore or dark spot visible in the reference photo. These tiny details will mimic the texture of skin, including scars. Once the details are drawn, use a kneadable eraser to lift excess graphite around the dots, enhancing their definition. This step will ensure the texture appears more pronounced and natural. Take your time during this process, carefully observing and replicating every little spot, as these fine details are crucial for creating a lifelike appearance. Patience and precision will make the texture and overall rendering look strikingly realistic. Now let's move on to the signature part of the drawing, the beard. Begin by taking your charcoal pencil and sketching the basic lines of the mustache hair. Pay close attention to the reference photo to replicate the direction and flow of the hairs accurately. Once the lines are drawn, use a short hair brush to gently smudge the lines for softening their appearance. Repeat this process, layering the charcoal pencil strokes and smudging them, until you achieve the desired darkness and density for the mustache. With this, also shade the lips. First, draw a dark line between upper and lower lip to create the illusion of shadow where they meet. Then, using a small brush, apply an even base layer to the lips with HP graphite powder. Smudge the charcoal around the shadow line to enhance the depth and dimension, giving the lips a realistic appearance. Once the basic structure is in place, use a pencil eraser to add fine details and subtle highlight to the lips, creating a texture or natural look. Now focus on beard. Take charcoal powder and apply it to the paper with medium-sized brush, carefully following the basic shapes and direction of the beard as seen in reference photo. Pay attention to the gaps and patches in the beard, ensuring these details are accurately represented. Lightly shade the surrounding areas around the beard and blend the charcoal smoothly to build depth. Extend the shading to the beard line to create the seamless transition. Once the base layer is complete, use your charcoal pencil to draw individual hair, mimicking their direction and density from the reference photo. For the right cheek area, make sure to recreate the slightly patchy look of the beard for adding authenticity. Afterward, use pencil eraser or mono zero eraser to add subtle highlights across the beard, which will enhance the texture and contribute to overall realism of the portrait. So that's it for this video, and in the next video we are going to complete this portrait, so stay tuned for the next part.